What's this?
Hello, welcome back to the Freak Show. Bumpy McSquiggums here. I want to thank you all for joining me as I continue with XCOM 2. That's right, folks. We're on episode 9. We are getting some stuff hammered out today. It is going to be a sweet and nice. I don't know. It's going to be okay, okay though, guys. It's fine. Or it's fine. Whatever it takes. It's okay. Apparently, Overstep didn't overstep enough to get a promotion, while Rise missed every single shot and did nothing that entire time except get owned. Yeah, that happened. However, everybody else pulled their weight and did something, and that is okay. That's cool. We got Lady Pogo Stick over here, getting ready to do whatever it is a Lady Pogo Stick get ready to do. I think we're going to go with Assault. We're just going to have her run up and just slice people to bits, and that's going to be the play. It's going to be sweet, sweet nice, as I already stated before, which is fine. All right, so that's done. Gravely wounded for 23 days. We are also shaken, which means our will is at a giant round circle of poo. Not great. Definitely not great, but that's okay. We will accept it and figure out a way of moving beyond. Alright, Tack got slapped around a little bit, but he's only wounded for 4 days. He's not really that upset. He's okay. He is okay. Alright, we're going to continue going down this side, but let's read what both things do. Send the Grumman to an ally to remove any negative mental status effects. Disoriented, stunned, panicked, or unconscious. Also, nail biting. And, I don't know, cud chewing, gum chewing? One of those has got to be a nervous disorder, right? And one is probably more to do with cattle than humans, but that's fine, it's neither here nor there. Haywire Protocol, you may target robotic and mechanical enemies with your gremlin, attempting to hack them and seize control. Just remember, this is what happens when you feed your Mogwai after midnight, I'm just saying. Not exactly the best idea. So we can actually hack robotic enemies. That's pretty sexy, I'm not gonna lie. I am actually stoked to see how all that plays out. Meanwhile, let's see what she gets. Oh, running gun? Oh, I'm so sad that we're over on this side. It's okay. Immediately enter concealment once per mission. Okay, so we can actually go back into stealth and sneak around and do sneaky, stabby, stab stuff, or just shooting things, because it's pretty hard to stab people when you are sneaking. Mostly due to the fact that they see you coming and then they freak out and they wet themselves. It's not great. Alright, run and gun, take an action after dashing. That's pretty fantastic. After dashing? Well, I suppose that is what it means. Yeah. Sorry, guys. Just the wording threw me off there. That's cool. It's just like run and gun always is. Alright, I got it. Well, we'll be able to go back into stealth and maybe get an extra murder-death shot out. I think that would be pretty good. Also, I think she should have, like, a better weapon. Like maybe a mini sniper rifle or something? I don't know. That's right, you should be ashamed of yourself, buddy. Rise, you failed me. You failed me big time, brother. You failed me big time. You hurt me. You cut me real deep, Shrek. Well, it looks like Liara Face Tank Jennings is going to be our top killer this time around. Short of a horrible, horrible, awful negative miracle happening. Alright, laser sight increased critical hit chance by 5%, improving even further with proximity to the target. That's pretty sexy. I like that a lot. Alright, we got all sorts of other various things. We got supplies. Ooh, we got Illyrium crystals. We were waiting on that. That's awesome. Okay, cool. And we can now perform the Viper autopsy as well. This creature is clearly reptilian in nature, although it appears to not only be sentient, but also highly intelligent. Still, the underlying physiology is remarkably similar to a number of terrestrial species, including the venom sacs, which we might be able to synthesize and incorporate for use in our medical supplies. Kinky. Onward? Yeah, you got shaken because you just sucked, and you probably got shaken because you took a few extra shots. Our intel is low? What does that mean? Intel is an important resource required to make contact with different regions around the world. To gain more intel, research any advent data pads or...
There's been plenty of gripes about my flying, but I don't see anybody else stepping up, other than the autopilot.
Okay. Or alien data caches your soldiers may have looted in combat. Scan at Resistance HQ with the Avenger, which will provide a steady stream of intel as you pass time. Certain missions, like Council missions and Guerrilla Ops, can offer large amounts of intel as rewards. These missions will appear regularly as you pass time. We had 80, now we only have 50. I wonder what's dropping that. I don't know how this all works 100% together just yet, folks. But we'll figure it out as we go. We'll figure it out. It's all good. It's all good. Alright, we were going to do stuff. Alright, the black market is now alive. Commander, the resistance has heard rumors of a black market in the wilderness near one of our havens. If we scan the area, we may be able to locate them and see what they have to offer. I'm going to ignore that for now. We have other various things that we need to do. I think we're going to go over here and try to get some more resources for our contacts. Resistance contacts, yeah. There's another heat signature laying around. No, that's what we actually got. Sensor detected an immense... we'll say okay for now. So we did that. So that actually improved our... Okay, that's pretty neat. I didn't know it was going to work like that, but that's cool. I like that a lot, actually. All right, we can gain more intel just by scanning if we needed to. We can get some more supplies over here. And then what is this down here? The black market. It's 5 days remaining. We can scan. We can gain intel. Or we can go and deal with the advent black site. I think we should wait until we have more people on board or online or alive or not wounded, whatever you want to call it. So we have a full party of at least specialized troops. Because things are looking a little bit rough right now. Will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander. Okay, resistance radio. Very nice. You don't have any witty quip to say here, no? Alright guys, pause and read as need be. And the Advent Stun Lancer Autopsy is now instant. Yay! Ooh, that's really cool. Alright, let's instantly research it.
The Advent Stun Lancer was apparently outfitted with the intention of serving as a civilian peacekeeping unit within the city centers. Although they are equipped with weapons capable of administering non-lethal blows, recent reports indicate an increasingly aggressive stance taken by these units.
Which sounds bad if you're not an XCOM, well, even if you were an XCOM person.
Clearly intended for these units to be their means of dealing with any unruly civilians within the city centers. It seems they have come to rely on more brutal means of pacification in the time since.
Indeed. Once again, guys, pause and read. Alright, onward. Ooh, the Arc Blade of Doom. Alright, when pure kinetic energy is no longer sufficient in the field, the Arc Blade may prove necessary. It boosts the standard sword's combat effectiveness with the addition of an electric field capable of stunning enemies that are not killed outright. Interesting. Is that just like a flat increase? I'm not entirely sure.
Apparently my predecessor was something of a brute when it came to handling the interrogation and autopsy of alien subjects.
Yeah, she was.
From what I've heard, she was keen to get her hands dirty whenever possible. Yes, Commander.
Yes, she was. Good old Dr. V. Dr. Valen was not exactly the kindest of individuals to alien specimens and species. All right, the Viper autopsy's there. I think we're going to do the data decryption.
I had assumed you'd make that research a priority, Commander.
You're welcome.
I'll notify you as soon as the report is available.
Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, no what? No radio something? I don't. It's whatever. All right, let's take a look at our armory and see how things are progressing over here. We shall view our soldiers. Shaken, 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 shaken. So we have a lot of shaken folk, but that's not necessarily terrible. We have a lot of Americans too, it seems. That's okay. That is all right. So 18 days, 22 days, 2 days. And 7 days. We'll see what comes. We'll see. We can go to engineering now as well. Hey, how's it going? Can we build items yet? Like the arc blade, for instance. Instantly build it. When pure kinetic energy. See, I don't. Is this going to be better than the sword? I have my doubts. Well, I'm going to build one, guys. We're going to hope that it's actually something cool. No way to be entirely certain, but we're gonna hope. Alright.
I saw Tygen muttering to himself in one of the corridors. I'm not sure he even noticed me. Bradford trusts him. but I'm still keeping my eyes open.
And you are right to do so, my dear. You are right to do so. He is a little
Commander,
bit of a muttery mutter.
Based on my research in collaboration with Shen, I believe we can reduce the intel cost of contacting additional regions by building radio relay towers along our network. The further a region is from a relay, the more it will cost us in intel. So I would suggest building relays along the remote edges of our existing network. I believe the Resistance will be grateful for the construction of these relays. They may reward us in kind.
Ooh, Shani, we like rewards. Of that we can be certain. All right, let's go and get some supplies. Uh-oh. I clicked on something. I don't know what's happening. Oh.
Commander, we've received word that the aliens have completed a facility devoted to their work on the Avatar project. If we can establish contact with the local Resistance forces in this region, we can make a move on that facility and destroy it to set back the aliens' operation.
All right, well, that's good to know. Unfortunately, we can't quite get there yet. We still have a little bit of a way to go before we can do that. Alien facility in East Asia. That is a tad unpleasant, to be sure. What is this? Lock and load. Personal combat sims and weapon upgrades may be reused. Make contact and install radio relays on this continent to receive this bonus. Huh. Radio relays. Okay, so we're learning some stuff there. That's cool. Communication from the Resistance. Commander, let's view it. Alright, Operation Ice Hole. You're such an ice hole. Alright, let's see here. Neutralize target in Advent Vehicle. Advent Vehicle. Hey, we'll get 88 intel, which is nice. All right, let's go handle it.
Mexican regional track.
To Mexico! Viva la Mexico! It's going to be fun, guys. We're going to do some murder, death, killing, I hope. Theoretically, this is true. All right, we have all of our own peeps up in the place to be. You're a squatty. You're a specialist squatty, though. All right. We have a grenadier over here. We have double specialists. I just want to see if there's anyone else I'd rather bring. Don't worry, Terrence, you're going to probably end up coming on the mission, but I'm just checking. I kind of want to bring Gunshow just to get her less shaken. So let's see here, what if we bring Gunshow? And then what do we have here? You are actually, okay. So you have the sniper rifle, that's not bad. Yeah, you know what? That's fine. We're gonna go this way. I guess that's okay. Get you to go. We're gonna actually drop Odie then. And what we're going to do instead is bring Terrence. We'll have dual specialists going. We're going to replace this with a med kit. That's pretty creepy, but I like it. Additionally, I like our grenades too much. I don't want to get rid of them. All right, we're fine. Let's go. Let's launch this bad boy and see what we can do. We're running the double
Sky Ranger deployed.
Specialist this time around. Squad green to deploy. Let's deploy. Let's get some killing going on and let's get this done, guys and gals. I'm hoping I can get all 10 episodes up tonight, guys. That's my goal. I'm shooting for 10. And I hope I can get all of them up. If not, I'll get probably 6 to 8 of them up.
In dealing with a VIP thought to be working with the aliens. The target is being moved by Advent forces through this area via one of their transport vehicles. Capture the VIP if possible. Engage as needed. Don't let the alien forces stand in your way.
But worst case, I'll get like 6, 7, 8 of them done tonight, and then I'll have a couple to do tomorrow morning, and then we'll be able to continue from there. With more recording, more XCOM 2, and more that Guile haircut. It is pretty awesome. Alright, our ragtag crew is ready. We have the crazy psychopathic axe murderer, also known as Tack the Dragon Rider. Lupus, for short, or for long, or just because. We have Liara, the cobra-killing snake lady of doom, or face tank Jennings. Come on, guys. Let's load this mission up. It's really, really long load times in comparison. It's kind of insane. Yay for smooth non-lagginess. Woohoo! Alright, there we go. I hope to see some customized...
Target location confirmed. Move to engage. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Thank you, Central. I don't hope to see some customization. I hope to see some optimization coming soon to a video game near yours. Oh, near XCOM 2. Okay, it's another timed mission. Again, guys, I'm not a big fan of this, but I've harped on this enough. I don't need to keep saying it. You guys know. You guys know. Oh, hi, random person.
We've been spotted.
Aw, is this real life? How were we spotted? By what? What spotted us? I'm so very confused right now. I don't know what's happening. Does that mean that person's an enemy? I'm so confused. I really don't know what to say or do.
Moving out.
All right, we're gonna back it up then. Because some seriously dark Juju Magumbo just went down. We have, like, absolutely no shot. It is actually quite disappointing. And disheartening. We're going to move... I guess to there. And we'll overwatch with our pistol, maybe? I don't know. Let's go to the gun show over here, boys and girls. Get Alexius Foreman ready and willing and eager and able. Terrence Grimlock, what are we going to do with you, buddy? What are we going to do with you?
Moving out.
I think we're going to move here. We're going to probably use the aid protocol to increase your defense. Yeah, there we go. Go over there. Do things. All right, it's the first time we've got to do that. Ooh, it looks shiny. Plus 20 defense. He is shiny. Very nice. And you're still concealed. Like I said, I don't know exactly what saw us the last time, other than just some random person happened to be in our way.
I'm all over it.
So we're gonna move up with Liara. And be prepared to do murder as they come forward. Or they're not gonna move and they're just...
That didn't feel good.
Really? You just shot me through a wall, okay. Because you're behind cover and it was like a 23%. Well, at least we flat murdered that guy. Made me feel a little bit better. Well, I gotta say, I'm not super happy with how that went down. Wasn't that TAC that just got wrecked? It was. Yep, TAC's like, oh, I'm good, guys. Don't even worry about it. I got this! And then, splat. Yep. That just happened, folks. That just happened. Alright, we're gonna move up with Alexis. Alexius, and we are going to shoot our frag grenade. We're going to blow a hole in the wall, remove his cover, do damage to him, and then get revenge. Maybe from our sniper, who might actually land a shot this time around. No way to be sure. Marksman, you would think, would actually be pretty accurate. We find that's not the case with us. Just saying. Though TAC is really, really looking for that revenge. I'm just saying. 75%, will you land it, sir? Your country needs you. He did, but it was a grazing shot, which is less impressive than it should be.
Howling idiot.
Yeah, I think you're a howling idiot, too. I don't know if that's what he said, but it sounded like it. And I think you are an evil, evil creature, is what I think. I think you have tricked us. And you are one of those mutated mutant guys with mutations and stuff. Alright, the Viper shall die. See, that's how you kill somebody. That's how you kill somebody. We need to heal him pretty badly. He is definitely not going to be enjoying life very, very soon. Get your flat top self over there, Terrence. Face tank is still stealthy.
Orders confirmed.
So we'll continue to move on, scouting our way to victory. This will move up and chill at the door.
Patrol on the move.
Oh, they're up on the second level. That's interesting. Alright, that's cool. At least it looked like they were on the second level. Whether they are or are not, I'm not entirely certain. Alright, let's throw out that heal.
Easy now, soldier.
Alright, so heal for all but one. That's something, I guess. Alright, we'll be able to move onward.
Moving.
Hoping that doesn't trigger the gloom and the doom, but I think it just did. Hey, do you see that? There's people over there. We should kill them. Let's jump. And make noises.
I'm spotted.
Oh, that's disappointing. Alright, Tech. What are we gonna do with you, buddy?
Moving.
Well, then we're gonna move you first. Alright, what kind of options? We got a 55 and we got a 34. Both of those seem kind of lame. What else do we have available? We have half cover over here against the weird little, I don't know, fountain thing. 48 and 27, which is bad. Alright, we're gonna go for the 48 with you. A rat tat 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 dead. Very nice, very good. I like it, I likes it a lot. Alright. I agree with you. Yep. Whatever you say, buddy. Whatever you say. 34, let's go for it. Ah, we did some damage to the wall a little bit, but not super impressive. Alright, coffee shop, what do you got for me, buddy? You've got literally no line of sight. That's not great.
Confirmed.
Confirmed. Alright, buddy, get on over here. We're gonna see if... Actually, she's not gonna be able to do anything, is she? Is she even behind cover at this point? Doesn't really look like it, does it? Alright, what if we move... here... Meh. I suppose we can move here. Maybe take a shot. It's not ideal.
Target identity confirmed. Menace 1-5. Remember, we're here to capture the VIP if possible. Knock him out and bring him in.
What? To capture the VIP, move a soldier to close range and use the subdue ability. Then carry the unconscious VIP to the evac zone. Well, that's a thing. But we're a little bit busy right now. How do we have 100%? Oh, what are we shooting at? I'm worried right now. Something's not right. It's saying we have 100% chance to hit and a 50% chance to crit, though here it says we have a 38%. I'm kind of worried. Oh god, what are we doing? No! Why would you...
Enemy destroyed!
Okay.
That is confirmed. Target eliminated.
Well, that happened. Surprise, guys. It didn't make any sense to me then. Still doesn't make any sense to me now. That's not who was targeting. And she got shot. That wasn't who we were targeting. It showed that guy right in front of us. I don't know what to tell you guys.
Menace 1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
I don't know what to tell you guys. That was some bull malarkey right there. But it is simply what it is. There's nothing we can do about it now. We're just going to have to accept it and continue our little adventure here. Hoping that we can actually get a kill. I like the way he was able to mark me and then still shoot me immediately after. That was something special. Alright, we're going to go for damaging his cover and potentially him. I think we might even blow up the floor here. Did he just fall? I think, yeah, he did. He just fell down. Yeah, so not 100% certain as to why or how specifically that stuff just happened, but it did. Did he die? I guess he did die. Okay. Well, there we go. That's apparently a thing that happened. It's kind of creepy. It's a little bit kooky, guys and gals. Alright, and we're looking at Snakey McGee and friend, and I think we're gonna probably try to blow up the area a little bit. I don't know if that's exactly what we want to do. I kind of wish this would get a little bit bigger of an explosion, but since it's not, we're just gonna blow up right there.
Get ready for a surprise!
I still can't believe that. It just, I'm like, it's saying that, like, we have a 100% shot, but it's saying we only have a 38% shot. It's showing that person, I mean, I don't understand, and then, yeah, sure enough. Sure enough, giant buckets of poo rained down from the sky. It was not great. 35%? Sure, we might be able to randomly make that shot. Probably not, though. Didn't really think we would, but yeah, I figured I'd take the chance.
Enemy is still up!
Yeah, enemy is still up, you're right. When you miss your shot, that is what generally happens. Alright, let's see. What's our best course of action? This is probably not it, but we'll still come over here anyway. Well, at least we can always try to exfil at this point. We might be able to get away, though it's not looking good. Alright, we come over here. Do we have any line of sight? We still have no line of sight. That's not great. Alright, we'll move over here. I think Bad Juju Magumbo is about to go down, folks. We are about to have something horrible. How good. Because we needed more reinforcements, because we're not already having enough issues. Cool. Got a leader with two flunkies or lackeys. Very nice. Welcome to the party. They seem pretty unhappy, I'm not gonna lie. Not as unhappy as that snitch person. What the?
I'm taking a fire.
Okay. Well, that was okay. Something.
You know
where you're moving? Not real well. Okay, that happened. That was mildly impressive. But the whole goal, guys, was to not get hurt so you could, like, recover. But apparently that's too hard for you guys to do. Well, Face Tank's dodging some stuff. She's doing some stuff there. It's not so bad. And the card's exploded. You're panicked.
Advised, hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position. Firebrand has a limited window to provide extraction.
Yeah, I'm aware of this. Thank you, sir. I am aware that the poop is about to hit the fan. It is literally stinking up the joint right now. Bad Juju Magumbo going down. Can we get this shot? We landed the 60. We got the kill. His head's resting on the snake body. That's kind of disturbing, if you want to call it something. Disturbing does work.
Location confirmed.
The location's confirmed. Really, we're going to go up high, huh? And then back down. Okay. Well, the most direct route, I guess, is a straight line. Alright, so Face Tank is like, this does not seem like a good idea. So, let's run over there anyway. I think we may have to conceal ourselves soon. Alright, we got an Illyrium core and another alien data cache. Not too bad. And we just, like, smacked the body or something. I don't know what we did there. It was a bit weird. We're going to move over here. We're going to try to hack whatever we can hack. Apparently there's something within hacking range no longer. I don't know what that was that we could have hacked. But we can't do it anymore. Alright, we're going to overwatch. There's the alien commander, who's also overwatching. And a little scrubby-dub-dub-dub guy there, and then this dude's coming on over as well. Alright, I believe our... Whoa! Are you kidding me? Really? Wow, that... Oh my gosh. These aliens are just insanely good at shooting things, like, ridiculously good. Like, we have a sniper that has less than a 1 in 3 shot, well, for the most part, to do anything. Let's see, can we land the 1 in 3 shot? I highly doubt it. Yep, nope, we can't land it at all.
Negative damage.
So it's not great, guys. It's really not great. I believe you probably should conceal yourself.
They won't see a thing.
And you should probably run away because you're going to die if you don't. Let's hope you can get over here. I'm glad that you've ranked up as much as you have, because if you didn't, you'd be dead right now, and we'd all be really, 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 really miserable, as opposed to only being massively, super, hugely miserable. Which is also terrible and really, really bad. Alright. So you are all reloaded. You are going to overwatch again. And you are going to move here, and we're going to try to shoot something if it's in our range. Which it's not, so we're going to overwatch as well. We have one shot. That's basically it. We have 7 turns to get out of here before bad stuff happens. Did we just get marked? We just got marked. Hey, our overwatch is actually going to work. Well, we're going to use it. I don't actually think we're going to hit anybody with it. No, of course not. Well, guys, I'll complain a little bit about RNG here and there. I'm going to try not to be super RNG negative, but I'm pretty bummed out already. Like, this is kind of bullcrap. Like, we actually have better troops than we've had in a long time, and we can't land anything at all. Literally nothing. It's not great. It's definitely not great. Alright, well, we're going to do this.
Rock and roll!
And we reloaded, and apparently we can shoot again? That seems interesting. Alright, we got a 56, we got a 35. Well, I guess we go for the 56. We can land the shot. Hey, we killed somebody. Woohoo!
Target neutralized.
We're not out of the woods yet, but that was a step in the right direction. Alright, we'll move up one step, and of course we're going to have to reload our weapon. And that's that. The gun show is here. We'll move the gun show over here. The soldier is definitely shaken. 28%. Ah, might as well. Let's go for it. Fire randomly. Maybe you'll hit him in a kneecap or something. Nope. No kneecap shots, guys. No kneecap shots. Alright. We got good old Grim Lock over here. 28 and 28. These are both terrible, terrible positions to be in. I guess we'll try moving to here. Alright, it looks like we can hack something. Let's just see what the hacking would do.
Attempting infiltration.
Maybe it'll give us a second move or something. I don't know. I don't think it's going to be that useful to us if it is. But, eh, we'll see. Maybe it'll just automatically kill people off. I don't know. There's always potential for something awesome going here. Soldier gains 1 free use of the run and gun ability. That's weird. Squad gains 1 free use of the run and gun ability. 54%. All enemies gaining defense and mobility. No, we're going to cancel that. It's not worth the risk. It is not worth the risk. I am sorry, folks. I would have loved to have done it, but it just doesn't seem like it would have been a viable option. But at least we know what's on the table. Alright, 29%. We went up by 1%. Maybe we land the shot. Maybe we miss like everybody else has. I don't know. It's too early to say. Alright, now it's up to Face Tank and her ability to murder fools from a distance, maybe, or something. I'm gonna go and stay behind full cover. I'm terrified to actually fire on anyone, as it will probably end my death. We're gonna go for it anyway. 67% is our best shot so far. We landed it. It's actually somewhat decent.
It's down.
Okay, yes, it is down. Alright, so they know we're there now. She's gonna move over. Now, is she going? She's going to overwatch. Huh. Wasn't really expecting that. And you just opened yourself up to this. Get handled. Or slightly wounded, I guess. Not as handled as I thought. And we might actually be able to get this kill. 69%. Will our sniper make up for it? Shooting through the hologram. Yes, he can. Alright, sweet. That was awesome. Okay. I guess the scrub-a-dub-dubs are pulling it together, and we may actually survive this. Pretty sure everyone's hurt, crippled, and going to definitely need some medical assistance after this battle. But that's okay. That is okay. Terrence, get on over here, buddy. Actually, I think Terrence is the only one who probably didn't get scratched this time around. Yet. It's not over yet. It's pretty close to over, but it's not over just yet.
Copy that.
Alright, so Liara is the last to move. We survived it. And I think we even have the sword thingy outfitted on her. I don't think I remembered to actually equip it, but I believe she has it auto-equipped, which is pretty cool. Because it does look like there's an orange glowy thing on her back. Coffee shop, buddy. We gotta get moving.
On the move.
We've only got 4 turns left before everybody must extract. Alright, let's get on over there. Is this guy gonna turn into something horrible and kill me? No? Yay! Give me a rope! Or give me death! We'll take the rope for right now.
Okay.
Alright, we'll move here. And I guess we'll do that. And onward and onward and onward we go. Eventually, we will be victorious in all things. My goodness, guys, this is a rough mission.
Just in time.
Like, those aliens were just, like, on point with their shots. They missed nothing. And they left us laying low.
Hostile interceptors are on high-speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
Yeah, we know. We know, we're stepping off. Don't worry, don't worry. We're getting out of here. We're on our way out. It's fine. Don't even worry about it. And with finality, coffee shop is the last one to go, and he will make it. Alright, so, one rule of thumb, you should not shoot the person you came to capture slash escort to the extraction site. That's not a good play.
Ready to boogie.
Just saying, that was a pretty bad failure on my part.
Mission accomplished.
Hey, it's an excellent mission rating. Woo! I actually thought more than 3 got wounded. Well, apparently only 3 got wounded. Who knew? But how badly were they wounded? Probably pretty badly. Well, again, our shot percentage was pretty high. We didn't kill a single alien every turn. We killed about 0.9 per turn. It could have been a lot better. Could have been a lot worse. 17.71% average cover bonus, not nearly enough. We definitely need more. And we did get wrecked pretty badly that time around. It was not a great experience for you, me, or anyone else. So my apologies to that, guys. When we get back to the base, I will actually break off the episode. And then in the next episode, hopefully things go a little bit better. We may have to give somebody else time to shine, because I believe some of our folks are, well, going to be hurting a little bit for a while. Those are my thoughts. I could be totally wrong, but, you know, I'm not. Alright, did we at least get some promotions? We did. Gravely, and gravely wounded. They trudged on back, and then they collapsed in a heap. It's kind of funny. Alright, let's promote you. Let's see here. Gun show. We're going to get you the Shredder as well. Very nice. We'll continue. And our squaddy over here, Terrence Grimlock. Welcome. We're going to have you as the actual medical protocol, so you are going to be a medic, my friend. Thank you for your service and your flat top hair. Alright, everybody else? Yeah, you're going to have to sit this one out. I know. It is pretty sad. So Tack got wrecked pretty bad, Liara got wrecked pretty bad, and sadly Gunshow also got wrecked pretty bad. We did get the Illyrium core and the alien data cache, so that's
Hello,
a good sign.
Commander.
We accidentally killed Beth Kelly, which was not the play. It was not the play. 174 supplies. Commander, while we are pleased that your team was able to neutralize the Advent VIP, we won't gain any intel from a corpse. Hey, you know what? That's still something from nothing, so I'll take it. I will take that. That was still not the worst thing that could have happened. Alright, folks, we're going to bring out the episode here. I hope you guys had some fun, and I will see you guys in just a bit with the last episode for today's recording. Anyway, until then, my name is Bumpy McSquiggums. Thank you for stopping by the Freak Show, and I will see you later. Going on.